Before I begin, I have an urgent call to action. I need your help, or more importantly, my boy, Dragon Ball Sensei, Jester, needs your help. He is the leader of a team that actually translates all these Dragon Ball fan mangas, and right now, he's running low on translators. He's sitting on a batch, a pile of fresh scans, but he's got no one to translate them for him. So, if you are a translator and you would like to join the Dragon Ball fan manga team, I'm going to go ahead and leave a link to Jester's Twitter page in the top comment. Go ahead and hit him up there. That way you can join the Dragon Ball fan manga translation team.
Prepare yourself, Dan Saiyan.
So last we left off in Dragon Ball versus Goku versus Android 21, we had Goku going into Super Saiyan Blue and trying to contend with Android 21's Majin transformation, but unfortunately he winds up short and he gets completely knocked out of Super Saiyan Blue. The situation is looking grim with Android 21 poised to eat Goku to further her own power, but then we get the iconic glow and a beautifully drawn animation transformation that has Goku transforming into Ultra Instinct Omen. And before Android 21 can even think, Goku is right up in her face using the speed and the strength of Ultra Instinct and pulverizes Android 21. A savage retaliation of Android 21 basically means nothing against Ultra Instinct Omen Goku, and I can tell you like this, this ability of being able to dodge anything is incredibly OP, and the only drawback to Ultra Instinct is the fact that he has a time limit of how long he uses it, or at least normally he does. So Omen seems to last a little bit longer than Mastered, but even at Omen, I wouldn't imagine that Majin 21 could even land a hit on Goku. So this fight basically is extremely short-lived because, again, Android 21 cannot break through the immense wall that is Ultra Instinct. So what she does is she had a fallback plan, similar to how when Goku fought Frieza, and if Goku defeated Frieza, then Frieza had one of his soldiers shoot Goku. This is Android 21's backup plan, and it is just really funny because she placed Cell right outside where they were fighting, like right there, just standing there. I'll be completely honest, I've analyzed this scene over and over again and I have no idea what the hell this means. Is Cell conscious? Is he in cahoots with Android 21? Are they working together? Who the hell knows? He's just standing there for some reason. I guess she placed him there. I'm thinking maybe she has him under some sort of hypnosis or something, placed him there, and then eats him for further power if she starts losing. That was her plan, and that's exactly what she does. She makes him into a cupcake and then eats him, transforming into that version of Android 21 that we remember from Dragon Ball FighterZ, the one that has the polka dots that Cell is so famous for. And apparently this makes her a lot stronger. It's almost like Cell absorbing the androids with Android 21. If she eats Cell, then she gets more powerful. And even though I prefer the original OG look of Android 21, or at least Majin Android 21, and if I had to fight between the Majin look and the normal look, I would say the normal look wins because I like redheads. But between this look, the normal look, and the upgraded Cell look, I would still have to go with the original. But the reason I like this Cell look is because I am a big Cell fan, and I love the fact that we're basically having a character here that's mixing elements of Cell and Majin Buu together, and all in the body of a Bay. So definitely kudos to Young Gigi for putting this hybrid in this manga. Now Android 21 is ready for round 2, and it seems like she is faster, she is stronger. Not exactly sure if Goku can dodge her abilities or not, or her moves, but it seems like he's directly actively going to meet them, so they are going blow for blow. So I'm not exactly sure if he's using Ultra Instinct right now, or at least the ability, but he is treating her like a greater threat, which honestly she is. Finally, we get some confirmation that Android 21 cell absorbed, yeah, she is a big threat because she actually lands a hit on Ultra Instinct and dodges one of his attacks. And so they go blow for blow back and forth. This is something that you'll definitely see in Young GG's works a lot of the time. You get a lot of power up here, power up there, blow for blow. That's basically it. A lot of his stories are basically giant fight scenes, which in my opinion is where Dragon Ball thrives. And there are different ways to do this. Obviously, this is the more traditional way, the more Dragon Ball Z way. But still, I definitely appreciate the fact that he is keeping to what these transformations have and what powers they yield. And I know Android 21 is a little bit lopsided with her power. She may be stronger than certain characters, she may not be, but she is ambiguous. At least Ultra Instinct is something we can gauge. And just like those classic DBZ days, it's time for a beam struggle. And I have such an affinity toward Ultra Instinct Goku's Kamehameha, mainly because he had one of the best, most badass Kamehamehas in all of Dragon Ball Super against Kefla. But this is one of the moves that I definitely would like to see in a fan manga like this, especially with UI. And it looks like Android 21 is going to meet him in this beam struggle that... who knows who the victor is gonna be. Now, this is where Goku fucked up. He had it in one-on-one combat, and he had it when it came to Hack's abilities. He could face her with his strength because UI Omen has a lot of strength, and Hack's abilities of Ultra Instinct make it so he can dodge about anything. So why he would go into a beam struggle with a character that seemingly has like an immense amount of ki, I don't know, but she ends up overpowering, or at least her attack ends up overpowering his Kamehameha wave and blasts him to smithereens, leaving him damaged, which is something he does not want to be in a fight against this character. But it is right here at this panel that I realized exactly what they were doing. Now, I do think that the power scaling for this chapter is pretty good, but I think that they were giving Goku the benefit of the doubt that he would use a beam struggle against this character, like not thinking strategically, because we obviously want Goku to get beyond this. UI Omen is not the pinnacle of UI. Perfected UI, that is the pinnacle, and obviously that's where this chapter is headed, with Goku about to go into UI Mastered. And that is the end of this chapter of DBVS. And I love the very ending of this, because this is one thing that Young GG does in a lot of his mangas, and that is he has a narrator, just like in the show, telling you what happened in the episode, what may happen in the future, similar to the very beginning of the chapter where he has somebody telling you exactly what happened last chapter. As far as this goes, I think that they are definitely amping up the abilities of Android 21 to a ridiculous extent. I don't think that she is this powerful, but she is so ambiguous. She only had a video game appearance that she could possibly be this powerful and even beyond this, honestly. So it's a perfect character for a what if, and this obviously is a what if scenario. And they went ahead and downplayed Goku's tactical abilities by making him think that a beam struggle was a good idea, which honestly it was not. But again, we have to get to that mastered UI, and this is the only path that we can go to get there. And obviously in the next chapter, he will go to that, and he will probably end up killing Android 21 in that chapter. But anyway, guys, let me know in the comment section below what you guys thought of this chapter of DBVS. This is going to be Blackscape signing off. Take care, guys.